Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve example problem 1.1 that is taken from chapter number 1, Stress, and book name is Mechanics of Material by RC Hibbeler and its 9th edition. So statement of problem is determine the resultant internal loading acting on cross section at C of the cantilever beam shown. So you can see this is a cantilever beam having triangular load. And this is fixed at point A, and we have been asked to find the internal loading at point C. So when you cut at point C, you can see you have two portion of the beam, CB and AB. So we will solve by taking this CB as well as AB. For CB to be taken, we do not need any reaction forces. So what we do is that we will cut the beam at this CB. And when you cut it, you will need the magnitude of distributed load at this point C. At point A, we have 270 load, which is 270 Newton per meter. So how we'll find this W? So again, you can see you have two triangle. One is this one and another one is this one. These are similar triangle. So the ratio of their side will be same. So if I take this 270 divided by whole length, which is 3, that will be equal to this W over the length which it acts, which is 6. From here we will get this W will be equal to 270 divided by 3 multiply by 6, and that will be equal to 180 Newton per meter. So this is the magnitude. Now what we will draw the pre-wire diagram of this beam portion CB. This is your point C, this is your point B, where you have a distributed load that is shown over here. The magnitude is 180 Newton per meter, clear? And this total length of this portion CB is shown as 6 meter. So this is 6 meter. So when you cut it, so you will be having a normal reaction force which is equal to NC, clear? You will be having a shear force in upward direction that will be equal to VC, and as well as you have a reaction moment that is counterclockwise. This is MC. So we'll find these are actually internal loading, NC, VC and MC. So we are going to find out this. So let's start with the solution. Again, you can see this is a triangular load. So when this triangular load is converted into point load, so it will be equal to 1 over 2 multiplied by 180 multiplied by the length over which it acts is, that is equal to 540 Newton. Okay, and that will act at a distance of L by 3 from this denser side. Okay, L by 3 from this side, and from point B, it is 2L by 3, where L is 6. So L by 3 from this side is 6 by 3, which is equal to 2. So I will write it, this distance will be 2 meter. Okay, now we can apply the equation of equilibrium. That first equation of equilibrium is that sum of all forces along x direction must be equal to 0, and force toward right is taken as positive. So only horizontal force is NC, and that is acting in negative direction. So it will be equal to 0. So from here, this NC will be equal to 0. So this is the first normal reaction force at point C. Now we can find VC by using equation of equilibrium, that sum of all forces along y direction must be equal to 0, and upward force is taken as positive. So you can see this VC is upward. So VC minus this 540 Newton is downward, is equal to 0. So VC is equal to 540 Newton. Okay. Now we'll find this MC. So for MC, we'll apply equation of equilibrium, that sum of all moments about point C is equal to 0, and taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. So about point C, one moment is reaction moment, which is MC. So I will write plus MC. And the second moment is due to this 540 load, and the perpendicular distance is 2, and it is producing clockwise, so it will be negative. So I will write minus 540 multiplied by 2 is equal to 0. So from here you will get this moment about point C is equal to 1080 Newton into meter. So this is the answer of our this question by using taking the segment CB. Now we will solve this by using this segment for segment AC, and you will see that we will get the same answer. So for that, again you can see that you will need reaction forces at A. So what we will do is that if you remove this support at point A, so you will be having a reaction force, horizontal reaction force, which is equal to RAX. You will be having a vertical reaction force, which is equal to RAY, and there will be a moment that is equal to MA. Clear? So we will find this reaction forces first. So how we will find first? So let's start with this solution of this segment for AC. As we have a uniform triangular load 1 to 270 Newton per meter, so it is when converted into a point load, so it will be equal to 1 over 2 into 270 multiplied by the total length, which is 9, over which this load is acting. So it will give you 1215 Newton load, and it will act at a distance of L by 9. So total length is 9, L by 3. So total length is 9. So it will 9 divided by 3 will be 3. So it is acting at a distance of 3 from this point A. Clear? Now we'll apply equation of equilibrium. That first equation of equilibrium, that sum of all forces along x direction must be equal to 0, and force toward this is taken as positive. Okay. So RAX is only for horizontal force. There is no other force. So RAX is equal to 0. Now you can apply another equation of equilibrium, that sum of all forces along y direction must be equal to 0, and upward force is taken as positive. So RAY is acting upward minus this 1215 Newton load is acting downward. Their sum must be equal to 0. So RAY will be equal to 1215 Newton. Okay. Now we will find this moment about point A. So we will take sum of all moment about point A is equal to 0, and taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. So MA is taken as counterclockwise, so it will be positive. The second force that is producing moment about point A is 1215 into perpendicular distance is 3, and that is clockwise, so it will be negative. So I will write minus 1215 multiply by 3. Here, and that is equal to 0. So from here you will get this moment about point B, point A. So moment about point A is equal to 3645 Newton into meter. Okay, now you have these three reaction forces. So what we will do is that we will cut this beam at point C and draw the free body diagram. So it will be like this. Let me draw it over here. This is your point AB, AC section. Sorry, this is A. This is your point C. Clear? And the length of this AC is 3 meter. Okay. We have a distributed load like this. Linear load or triangular load at point C will be like this. Okay. Here the magnitude is 270 Newton per meter, and at point C you can see that at point C, W at C was 180. So this is 180 Newton per meter. Now what we will do is that we will convert this load into combination of two. One for distributed load for entire length of 3, and the remaining this portion will be a triangular load. So I will do it like this. This is total will be 180. So 270 minus 180, this will be equal to 90 Newton per meter. Okay, so when you convert this distributed load into a point load, so it will be equal to 180 multiplied by 3, and that is equal to 540 Newton. Clear? And it will act at a distance of L by 2, which is 3 divided by 2 is 1.5 meter. And for this triangular load, you can see 90 is perpendicular distance and base is 3. Clear? So when this distributed, triangular load is converted into a point load, so what we will do is that this will be equal to, this load will be equal to, I will write in green color, 1 over 2 multiply by 90 into 3, and that is equal to 135 newton load. This load is this one there, and that will act at a distance of L by 3. So 3 by 3 is 1 meter from this point A. So again, at point C, when you cut it, so you will be having a normal force in C direction, which is NC, and you will be having a shear force, which is VC, and you will be having a moment that is MC. So we are interested to find out NC, MC, and VC because these are the internal loading. So for that, we will apply equation of equilibrium. So first equation of equilibrium is that sum of all forces along x direction must be equal to zero. One more thing I forget here to mention, that is at point A we have RAX, which is zero. Clear? So RAY is there. So I will write RAY. And you have a moment which is MA, that was taken as counterclockwise. So MA. Now we will apply equation of equilibrium. So first equation of equilibrium is that sum of all forces in x direction must be equal to zero. So you can see there are one force, which is NC, is acting, and there is no other force. So NC will be equal to zero. Now we apply another equation for finding VC, and this is the equation of equilibrium. So VC minus VC, because it is acting downward, plus RAY is 1215 minus this 540 newton load minus this 135 newton load is equal to zero. When you solve this, you will get VC will be equal to 540 newton load acting at point C. Now the last thing is that sum of all moment about point C is equal to zero in order to get moment at point C. So moment at point C is MC, which is clockwise. So I will write minus MC. Clear? Starting from this point, the one moment is MC. The another moment is due to this load, which is 540 into perpendicular distance is 1.5. And this is counterclockwise, so it will be positive. So I will write plus 540 into 1.5. The another moment is due to this load, which is 135, and now perpendicular distance is 3 minus 1 is 2 meter, and that is also counterclockwise, so it will be positive. So I will write plus 135 into 2. Clear? And the moment about point A, which is 3645, that is counterclockwise, so it will be positive. So I will write plus 3645. And the last moment due to this load, which is RA, and RA is 1215 into perpendicular distance is 3, and that is clockwise, so that is negative. So I will write minus 1215 multiply by 3. The sum of all moment about point C must be equal to 0. So when you solve this MC, so you will get MC will be equal to 1080 newton meter, and which is the answers of our this question using this portion AC. Now we have concluded that if you are going to take this side or this side, so the resultant internal loading at point C will be same. So we have seen that if you take this portion CB, you have these values, and you, if you are taking this segment AC, you are getting the same answers. So no matter whatever section you take, you will get the same answer. And that was all about this example problem 1.1. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my upcoming videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.